Hey y'all, so I'm back with another wall art. I remembered to bring my little camera stand again. So today I'm working on a tree mural for a daycare center. And I have a little bit of tricks to show you guys. So because the tree is pretty full, it's just easy right now to just apply the paint with a roller. And I basically kind of just did like a free roll where I didn't really sketch out anything because I can always go back in it with a brush to add the size that I want and along with the details that I want. I actually really enjoy doing the daycare murals because it kind of feels like I'm doing a really big coloring book. It's really free, it's fun, it's vibrant. I don't have to do a lot of measuring. I don't have to use tape too much. So I just rather kind of do the daycare murals versus the home decor type accent walls. Okay, so we have the first layer of green put down. Because the wall was previously painted with like a semi-gloss paint, I had to let it dry a little more because when you put the second coat over top of a wet paint that's on semi-gloss, sometimes the paint comes up and it doesn't stick. So we're gonna let this dry a little bit and then we're gonna come back and I'm going to do a second layer. So the green is dry enough, so right now I'm going to use my sponge to try to give it a more textured look. I really enjoyed using the sponge. It really made it look textured. It was easy to do. I just used a lighter green to give it a more highlight effect on the edges. And I was able to finish this in no time. Okay, so as you can see, I did the outer part of the tree where it's a little bit lighter. You see? So now I'm going to go in and add some leaves using one of these paint brushes. I don't know which one is going to give me the better effect and make my job easier, not harder. So I'll show you which one works better for me and I'm going to add some stuff. The rest of the leaves are going to be added once I do the barks and trunk of the tree. I just automatically went into it with the angle brush and just adding some leaves, and it's coming out really nice. I'm really loving the effect. So we're gonna do these little random leaves all over the tree. And then after I add the chunks and the bark, I'll add some leaves, more leaves to the tip. Do a close up. Just random green. Okay. So as it dries, it's going to fade in a little more into the background, which is what I want. Okay. So once this dries up a little bit, I am now going to add the branches and the base of the tree.
Okay, so I'm going to show you how I usually eye stuff. So I'm going to work on the base of the tree. It's pretty wide at the bottom. I don't know if you can see it like that. So I'm just not doing it exactly like this, but similar to. And again, I don't really pre-sketch this. I just pretty much go right in with the paint, okay? All right. I use a skinnier brush first. This dry so that I can go in it and add some of the details for the trunks and the main part of the tree. Dry time, be dry for right now. So now I'm gonna do the little bit of highlight details in the tree. So in the original picture, the highlight is actually a more of a white hue. So I'm gonna use that and I'm gonna start off doing the trunks, and I'm gonna let my phone charge a little bit because it is dying and I just gotta be transparent. But once I get towards the middle part, I will show you how I'm doing the process of highlighting the trunks. All right, so I finished one little side of the tree.
I'm going to do the other side and the bottom nail. I have this dark mocha color that I'm going to use to add a little bit of shadows to the tree. The bottom of the tree has more of a rooted design in it, so hopefully I have enough juice to actually catch that. How cute was these little ladder, the little squirrel ladder going into the hole? So cute. All right, y'all. Thank you so much for tuning in. Make sure that you like or comment. And definitely subscribe.